And that's on doing 4 parks in one day, ladies and gentlemen. That's how it's done. Hey vlog, welcome back to another video. So today is finally my day off. And I had kind of a fun video idea. So it is the 50th celebration right now. It's been open for 50 years.
Crazy.
In honor of that, they set up like 50, or I think it's 36. They set up 36 of these gold stat, or not gold, maybe gold, I don't know. They set up these statues all around the park, all 4 parks that is. So I thought it'd be fun to go and look at all the statues and take a fun little wide angle selfie in front of them because I am very good at taking wide angle selfies. As you could tell. So right now I am at the boardwalk. Here I am. And my first park that I am going to hit is going to be Epcot. And along with seeing the statues, I'm hopefully gonna do at least one ride in each park. We'll see though. I've heard it's pretty busy today. So fingers crossed we're able to do that. But we'll check in when we're at Epcot. In just seconds, because of the magic of editing. We made it to Epcot, and it is in Epcot today. Oh my gosh. Good thing I'm not here for the whole summer. Anyways, I came here a few days ago, so I know where some of them are. So, let's go and look at the statues. I'm very excited. These ones are very cute, so let's do it. Hi, friends. So, we just were in like the center area of Epcot, and that is where we saw the majority of the Epcot statues. We saw Dante and Miguel, Rocket Raccoon and Baby Groot, Pua and Hey Hey, and Olaf and Bruni. And there is only one statue left in Epcot, and that is Figment, who is literally my favorite character ever. But he is more towards the Epcot ball, and right now we're right by the Mexico Pavilion, so I thought we would go on the Grand Fiesta Tour, because I think that wait is only like 10 minutes, and it's indoors, so I can hang with that. So with that being said, let's go on the Grand Fiesta Tour and then we will take our last selfie with one of these statues. This is also my first time like going to a park alone. Feeling kind of awkward, but also feeling like a main character. So take that as you will. Hello there. So we just got off the Mexico ride. The wait said it was 20 minutes, which I thought it was gonna be longer because we had to actually wait just to get inside of the Mexico Pavilion, but it was still basically 20 minutes, but that's always a fun ride. All right, and right now it is about 2 p.m., which means that I am able to park hop now. So I just need to go take my picture with the Figment statue and then we will be on to the next park. So let's go. Let's go find Figment. That one is amazing and honestly might be my favorite one. So, that being said, let me stand in the shade while I talk to you. We just saw all of the Fab 50 statues that are at Epcot. So that means there is a total of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 50th statues in Epcot. I'll put all the selfies at the end of this video because I just feel like if I put it in right now, it would just be absolute chaos. So expect those at the end. So with that being said, 6 down, 30 more to go. And we are now off to Hollywood Studios next. So I'll see you there. So, for the first time literally ever, I got my own Skyliner. How fun is this? All alone. We're about to take off. Here we go. Yay! Wow, how fun is this? Are you kidding? I just took the Skyliner from Epcot to Caribbean Beach, and then I had to transfer, and now... Oh.
Ladies, gentlemen, and islanders of all ages, welcome aboard the Disney Skyliner at Disney's Caribbean Beach Resort. We're flying to Disney's Hollywood Studios.
She said it for me. We're going to Hollywood Studios now, so we'll check in there. So cute and fun. There was Donald and Daisy. We've made it into the park. Here we are in Hollywood Studios. Let's go find those statues, like I've said like 8 times. Now we're actually gonna go find them, I promise. We are really having a fun little character interactive moment. So there's Chip and Dale, and that was the Joe statue from Seoul, which that one was really cool. I did like that one a lot. I see Woody and Bo Peep right in front of me. So I've got to go take my selfie with it. There's so many people around. This is so embarrassing, taking these wide-angle selfies. Okay, whatever. My photo got interrupted there by... which one was that? By Chip, but I don't think I'm disappointed. That one is literally my favorite. I love that. Okay, let's take a look at which ones we have seen and which ones we are yet to see. So we've seen Joe Gardner from Seoul. We saw Edna right behind me. We saw Woody and Bo Peep, Frozone, Sebastian and Flounder. The only two we have left are R2-D2 and BB-8, which I see right now. So let's go and take a video of them and check them out. Check them out. Okay, that was weird. So those were easily the most embarrassing ones to take pictures of, because those were located right in front of like a dining area. So I basically just took a selfie in front of everyone, but honestly, I think they enjoyed it, so it's not that big of a deal. But instead of going on an attraction, I think we are going to hit Starbucks, which is kind of an attraction for me, I guess. It's still fun. Just because I was looking at all the wait times. The ride that I wanted to go on was Mickey and Minnie, but it's 105 minutes, which that would be quite a while. And the other ride that I was thinking about was Toy Story Mania, and that's 80, which is also a no-go for me because of that point. Sorry, I need to make some power moves with my walk-in. Okay, we could chat now. Because at that point, then it would be too close to 7, and if transportation goes sideways, I would not be able to get to Animal Kingdom, which that's the whole point of this video, is to go to all four parks. So, let's do it. Let's go to Starbucks, which I'm equally as excited for, so it's fine. Honestly, I could go for an iced chai. So I got my Starbucks, I got an iced chai, of course, but they have pumpkin cream cold foam here, which I feel like a lot of places don't have anymore, because it's just simply not that season. But I probably waited like 25 minutes for this, so I probably could have gone on a ride or something, but it's okay. So it is almost 3 o'clock now, and we are going to go to Animal Kingdom. And I looked at the wait times, and they do not look bad, so fingers crossed it stays that way. I think I'm gonna go do Dinosaur when I get there. That's at least what I wanna do. I'll probably just end up doing it anyways, because I honestly haven't waited in that long of a line yet today. I mean, I've only done one thing, but you know, whatever. So that's my plan, and then after that, we'll go to Magic Kingdom, which I'm honestly really excited for Magic Kingdom, because I haven't been to Magic Kingdom in a while, besides like when I work there, obviously. I'm walking over to the bus stop, and I'm gonna take the bus to Animal Kingdom, and I'll see you there. Look, it's me, the Allioramus. So if that wasn't a giveaway, I made it to Animal Kingdom, and I ran over to Dinosaur, because when I got on the bus, I was feeling a little bit worried, because the wait time said it was 50 minutes, which I was like, that's a little bit of a long wait. But then I get here, and I check again, and it said 35, so I skadoodled my booty over here, and I probably waited like 20 minutes, if even. So that was really awesome. Now I need to go and find the statues and take a picture. But before I do that, I wanted to talk about how I literally am such a clown, because I completely forgot that single rider existed, because I looked it up online to see if this ride had single rider, and then it popped up that Rock and Roller Coaster and Test Track had single rider, which I've literally done single rider for those before. So I could have done a ride at Hollywood Studios. Absolute clown right here. I guess we'll just have to go back and...
Not today.
But we'll have to go back at a different time and ride those rides. I'm so bummed though, I completely forgot that was a thing. But if you're ever wondering, Dinosaur does not have single rider. The only ride that has single rider in Animal Kingdom is Everest, but it's closed right now, so it doesn't even matter anyways. It's 4:32, I just saw all the statues that are in the Animal Kingdom. We had Nemo and Dory, Simba, Timon and Pumbaa, and Bambi and Thumper, which all the ones here were super cute, and they had like such a cute backdrop because they all were right by the tree. Loved all those, very photogenic statues over here in Animal Kingdom. So now we are exiting the park. The music is really loud over here, so I'm sorry if you can't even hear me. But we are exiting the park and off to Magic Kingdom we go. So back to the buses.
Yeah, look it.
Ooh, that's delicious.
I know I said we'd check in at Magic Kingdom, but there's just an animal actively out, so I thought I would document that. Also, can we talk about that guy saying that looked delicious?
That's delicious.
we're not even gonna think about it. Okay, we'll see you at Magic Kingdom. Adios. Hey guys, so after about 40 minutes of transit situations, I've made it to Magic Kingdom. It's about 5:20 right now, and yeah, that's that. So didn't have to wait too long for the bus. I was worried because there was a Magic Kingdom bus that pulled away like right when I got there, and I was like, oh my god, you're kidding. But then one showed up in like 10 minutes, so it wasn't that big of a deal. But anyways, here's the castle. How cute is she? Okay, so I don't normally do these like recaps like after I do one, but I just took a picture at the Tinkerbell one, did my wide-angled selfie, and this girl comes up to me and is like, oh, do you want me to take a picture of you? And now I'm just so embarrassed because it wasn't supposed to be a good picture. I was just having fun and taking a wide-angle picture, and now I feel awkward. But anyways, on to more. I honestly would very much recommend doing this. This is like a fun little scavenger hunt, at least in Magic Kingdom, because they're actually all spread out. Like, I know the orange bird is in Adventureland, so I'm walking there now, but it's also just sheer chaos right now because there's a parade happening or about to happen, and there's just people everywhere. But it's fine. We're getting through it. We're getting them done. My pictures are literally getting terrible, but I think that's kind of the charm in this, maybe. I don't know. They're not supposed to be good. Remember that. Remember that. All right. So I've been walking around for a bit, and I haven't found all of them yet, but it is about 5:45, so I know that there are two cavalcades that are coming past in a second, so I'm just going to hang out here. I'm right by the Frontierland stores. The general store, I guess is what it's called. So I'm just going to hang out here, watch the two cavalcades, and then we'll get back on the hunt for finding these statues. Daisy, we saw Pluto, we saw Chip and Dale already, Orange Bird we saw, Dumbo and Timothy we saw, Pooh and Piglet, and Tinkerbell. So we still have a few left, but those are the ones we've seen so far. I literally, besides Stitch, I have no idea where any of the other ones are, so this is gonna be fun. So I had a strong feeling that Abu would be in Adventureland because Aladdin, I don't know, and they have the Aladdin ride, but I just like walked the whole area back and forth. No Abu, so maybe I'm blind or he's just not over there. Either are very valid options. Now this is a tricky one. Do you see him all the way up there? Wow, I'm impressed that I noticed him. Okay, that was a tricky one. I'll give that one to Disney there. Now I'm gonna hold my breath and try and skadoodle up Main Street, because I know Lady and the Tramp is over there. Wish me luck. It looks like sheer chaos. All right, so I just got the Lady and the Tramp one, and now we're on to my favorite 50th statue, Stitch. All right, so that was Stitch back there. And now since we're in Tomorrowland, and I need to do an attraction for sure before my camera dies and before we wrap up this video, I was like, what's a fun attraction in Tomorrowland? Most people probably think of Space Mountain, but right now, I think it's time for a trip to the turn of the century. That means we're going on the Carousel of Progress. Thrilling, I know. Now, the Carousel of Progress is overall iconic, just like in existence, but there's one part in particular, which is my favorite part, so we'll put that in right now instead of me filming the entire ride.
I think I'll take one of those newfangled trolleys down to the drugstore soda fountain and meet the boys for a cold sarsaparilla. I'm sorry, I forgot. We're drinking root beer now.
All right, it's dark outside now. That's a fun little surprise. But it is currently 6:40. I'm hoping to find all the statues before like 7:30, and then I'm gonna try to get to Main Street to watch the fireworks. So that is my current plan. I'm pretty sure the ones we have left are in Fantasyland. They're all like Alice in Wonderland, Cinderella characters, so I'm feeling like they'd be hanging out in Fantasyland. Not 100% sure. But yeah, and then hopefully after the fireworks, I'll get to go on maybe one or two more rides, and then I'll call it a night. I cannot believe I'm still out here because I literally work so much that I should be exhausted right now, but I think I'm just enjoying the moment or whatever you want to call it. Okay, that was cringy. All right, let's find the rest of these statues. So we just saw the Mad Hatter, Cheshire Cat, Pinocchio, and Lumiere and Cogsworth. There were a ton of people by the Lumiere and Cogsworth one though, so my picture was literally trash.
You what?
But I took one, nonetheless. And now we've run into our first issue. The issue is that since the fireworks start in like an hour and a half, they've blocked off an area of Fantasyland where Jack and Gus's statue is. So that's awesome. Not sure how we're gonna get to it. I'm hoping that we could beat the people that put the rope up on the other side, because they like literally just put the rope up. So I'm hoping that I can boogie to the other side of the castle and sneak in and see it. Fingers crossed. Not sure. If not, I guess we'll just have to wait till after the fireworks, which is fine, but ruins my plan. Okay, so the fireworks have messed me up now, and I couldn't even get to making a mini because there are just people everywhere. So that's awesome. I'm gonna just hang out until after the fireworks, then we're gonna have to finesse a photo. So that's a bummer, but it's okay. We'll make it work. Hello, vlog. It's been a second. So it's currently 7:30 right now. So the fireworks start in 30 minutes. I was gonna watch them on Main Street, but things are just looking a little bit scary, so I'm thinking I'm gonna boogie back to Fantasyland and watch them there. So then I'm right by the Gus and Jack statue. Big brain moment for sure. Although I don't know if I could get to Fantasyland. This looks rather chaotic in front of me. Hoping for the best. Okay, you guys, so I've claimed my trash can in Fantasyland, and I am ready to watch the fireworks. I think it's an okay view. I think we'll be fine. Okay, you guys, I'm still standing here, 10 minutes till the fireworks, and this family comes up to me and asks me where Tomorrowland is. I guess I just exude I work at Disney vibes. So that's awesome. Big Disney cast member moment. I directed them to Tomorrowland with a two-finger point, of course. So that's how it's done, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, now we're gonna watch the fireworks. Confirmed, I am the biggest clown ever. It wasn't where I thought it was, because there's like the Cinderella fountain, which I was like, oh, that would make sense. Like, I'm looking for it, the mice from Cinderella, so obviously they'd be by Cinderella. Not the case. I guess they're actually in front of the castle, so I could have got to it that entire time. But I guess now I gotta watch the fireworks, so It's fine, but I just felt kind of silly. But also, look at how pretty the castle looks. Hello? So cute. Okay, now I have to fight the mass of humanity again in order to get to where I was before, but it's fine. It's fine. Okay, so there was Jack and Gus, literally right where I was 2 hours ago, but no worries. Now we still have our hardest struggle, which is Mickey and Minnie, because there's like a photo pass person in front. Okay, magical moment of the day. My camera literally died right when I got the shot of Mickey, so we did it. We did all of the statues. Here is Minnie and Mickey. They were very cute, but yeah. So now on to the outro that I filmed a while ago. Good thing I filmed it since my camera's now dead. That's what I'm thinking ahead. Well, you guys, since I'm sitting here, I'm filming my outro. So this was from a little bit earlier. So I'm gonna assume we were able to take pictures at the other 50 of statues. Now it would be a perfect time to put in all of my selfies that I took across the Walt Disney World, Walt Disney World Resort today. Like I said, they're all special in their own way, and just don't pause on them for too long because they're quite embarrassing. So enjoy. I hope you liked that. With that being said, I hope everyone is having an amazing day. Like I plugged a lot last video, I did make a Disney College Program Instagram. It is Putting the Owl in Magical. So I recommend you go follow that if you want to keep up with my life besides what I post on YouTube. And yeah, with that being said, I hope you all are having an amazing day. Thank you so much for watching. And as always,
go Utes.